Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. This is a problem from the Azerbaijani Olympiad. Pause video if you want to give this problem a go. And when you're ready, we'll go through the solution. To begin this problem, if we start by assuming that M will have at least three prime divisors, say P, Q and R, then the number of divisors D of M would be 2 times 2 times 2. That's because each of P, Q and R is to a power of 1, and so it has two possibilities for its indice, namely 0 or 1. So we have 8 divisors here, which would be bigger than 6, meaning that we can say that M must have at most 2 prime divisors. So for M to have 6 prime divisors, it could be either P to the power of 5 or P squared times Q, where P and Q will be some prime numbers. And in the first of these cases, where M is P to the 5, the sum of these divisors would be 1 plus p squared, add p cubed, add p to the 4, and p to the 5. And this needs to all sum to 3,500. And we can check that when p equals 3, the left side gives a solution which will be smaller than 3,500. But when p equals 5, we have a solution which will be bigger than 3,500. And because the left side is strictly increasing, we can say that no solution exists. So if we then consider when m is p squared times q, then the sum of these divisors would be 1 plus p plus q plus pq plus p squared and finally p squared q, which will give a total of 3,500. Now the first four terms can be factorized as p plus 1 times q plus 1, and the next two can be factorized as p squared times q plus 1. So we can factorize this once more as q plus 1 times p squared plus p plus 1. And the prime factorization of 3,500 is 2 squared times 5 cubed times 7. Now we can spot that p squared plus p plus 1 is odd for all values of p, meaning that q plus 1 must be divisible by 4. So we can write that q plus 1 is 4k for some integer k. And so substituting this in, we have that k times p squared plus p plus 1 is 5 cubed times 7. And it's not too difficult to check that p squared plus p plus 1 is always going to be either 1, 2 or 3 mod 5. So we can say that p squared plus p plus 1 is never divisible by 5, so therefore k must equal 125. And so q, which is 4k minus 1, is 499. This also tells us then that p squared plus p plus 1 is equal to 7, and so p equals 2, and hence m, which was p squared times q, will be 1996. And so we're done.